Hello everyone, I'm going to work on the last step of this large dot piece, and I'm starting with a butterfly spells on top of the magenta color. There you can see it, but it's a smaller dot so I can see the magenta color through it or beside it. I also added a fourth layer of resin. And this will be the last dots I'm going to place on top of this piece. The next color, that's the pure sunshine. And I will place it on top of the ginger magic. And this way I can also create the depth on the outside. Very nice bright color, and also a smaller dot. Yeah, and this was a piece that took a lot of time, but I had so much fun making it. And it was my first try to make a large dot piece. I never done it before, so it was also a learning curve. But I like it very much, and it's very relaxing to do. Also in this video, the unmolding of the piece. Then you can see if how the unmolding goes, if it goes easy or not, because I normally have Vaseline on the inside of the weather card, but this time I used an acetate strip. So yeah, we are going to find out how that worked. The next color is the lime peel, and I'm placing it on top of the crystal green. Very nice bright color is this. Also a smaller dot. And also in this video, of course, the end result. But that's at the end of this video. So if you want to see that, then you can wait for it. Also a close-up of the piece. And I'm also very happy that I've chosen a black background, because the colors are very bright this way. Looks great. And also great depth in it. Yeah, it's very difficult to see it on the video, but it has some great depth. The next color is the rich turquoise. And I'm placing it on top of the ice blue of DecoArt. Smaller dot. And again, also in this video, all the materials I've used are listed in the beginning of this video, but also in the description box with all the links where I buy my materials, also all the links in my influencers Amazon store. So if you want to see which colors, then you can check that out. And the next color is the Crocus Fields. Very nice purple color. Like this one very much. A small dot on the purple pearl of DecoArt. Yeah, and I'm going to add another layer, but then the paint needs to dry first. So it's time to take the dot piece out of the mold. The paint has dried, and Yeah, let's see how that goes, because I have an experiment with the acetate on the inside, and yeah, let's see if it comes out easy. Now I'm trying to pull the acetate sheet I have underneath the piece downwards, and I'm also pushing the weather card to the outside. There you can see it. But yeah, I'm not that pleased how it goes out of the mold. I have a difficult time getting it out. You can also see that some acetate sheet strips are sticking to the sides. But I need to get it out, and yeah, I can fix it, that's no problem. But it would be nice if it went a little bit easier than I have now. So I'm pushing the weather card to the outside. And I'm trying to get the acetate sheet loose from the piece. So this was not such a success. You can see I have some acetate sticking onto the sides, so I'm trying to get it off. And that, I get it off, but yeah, it's not the way that I want to remove a resin piece out of the mold. But I wanted to show you this also. That yeah, sometimes things go wrong, but I can fix it, no problem. I need to sand the sharp edge of the last layer anyway. But yeah, this was also an experiment, and now we know that this isn't such a success. Some places on the sides are very good, but the other side is not that good. There you can see it. So I could fix the issue I had with the unmolding. And I've added a layer 5, and I also added some sparkle on the outside. I've used the Stardust of Lures, very nice sparkly pigment powder. And I'm very pleased how this piece turned out. And it sparkles a lot, it has a great depth, very nice bright colors. And what I already said, I've sanded the sharp edge of my fourth layer, and I also sanded the sides because I had a problem with the unmolding. And after that I taped the back, and I gave it another top coat with the sparkly pigment in it on the side. And yeah, it looks great, and it's not totally done because it will get a metal hook on the back, because it's going to be a wall piece. And I hope that the person I made this for likes it very much. I hope she does, and I'm very pleased with it. There you can see the depth. Yeah, so if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. If you have tips, comments or questions, please place them under the video or send me an email. All the links you want to know are in the description box where I buy my materials, but also the links to my Facebook and Instagram. And I want to thank you all for watching. And I hope you like this process. And I will see you in the next video. Bye.